Many are confused about what drawing tablets and what different types exist. Let's change that. Ain't nothing like a good drawing tablet video, am I right or am I right?
First off, guys, this technology is nothing new, but it is interesting. Boo-hoo. But guess what? It is possible to get them back. There's actually a few ways to do this. For those of you that complain about long drawn-out videos, you can also see how drawing tablets actually work in detail by visiting our resource page. Go get it, girl, for show.
Girl? For show.
Now, to see that resource page, visit Google and type Media Peanut, followed by How Do Drawing Tablets Work. Should look a little something like this. However, if you don't want to move your thumbs, then you can enjoy the long, boring, drawn-out video. Totally kidding, by the way.
Oh, and don't you dare like, subscribe, or even comment. Because, well, we won't be answering them. Oh, and a ho-ho-ha-ha-ho to you too.
Drawing tablet works, and the differences between them, then you're in the right spot. In this video, we're going to cover which drawing tablets work best depending on whether you're an artist, graphic designer, photo retoucher, or just a business professional using a whiteboard for Zoom meetings. Those that plan to use a tablet to draw will need to know a few things. For starters, drawing tablets and graphic tablets both work in a similar manner regarding connectivity in order to draw lines digitally. So, how do drawing tablets work? Drawing and graphic tablets work by connecting an electronic drawing tablet to another device such as a laptop or desktop computer either wirelessly or through a USB connection. It works by using a stylus pen and drawing on the tablet, which will then digitally transfer the lines and strokes onto your main device. The drawing tablet will recognize the drawing stroke by utilizing either an active or passive stylus and then transmit the stroke using pressure sensitivity and other features to stimulate a true pen on paper experience. How exactly do you use a drawing tablet? You'll first connect your tablet to your laptop or computer and download the drivers and software that the manufacturer informs you of. This is usually on their website. Next, you'll ensure that your chosen drawing pad or graphics tablet is compatible with your operating system and drawing software application needs. Then finally begin drawing on your preferred software such as Adobe Photoshop, Krita, DaVPaint, or Toon Boom. There is a clear difference between a drawing and graphics tablet, as some have a built-in screen and other are just a pad. Both drawing tablet types require a software you will install on your laptop or computer. In this video, we'll cover how drawing tablet work and how graphic tablets work by providing a full understanding from start to finish. You'll learn how to use a drawing tablet to achieve whatever your drawing goals may be. In general, drawing tablets and graphics tablets are used by designers, artists, and photographers for digital tasks such as drawing, graphics, and animation. Drawing tablets and graphics tablets both work in the same way. Now you have two options here. One, you can sit through the next 8 minutes of video like Jabba the Hutt. Or two, in 0.5 seconds you can instantly see the steps and solutions, which is laid out clearly on our website. Go to Google. Type Media Peanut, then How Do Drawing Tablets Work? Look for the Media Peanut website. You'll be able to instantly see the solution and view all the hard-to-find information you need.
This video will still be available on that page if you need it. Now, when I say the page has everything you need, it really does have everything you need. Go get it, girl, fo show.
Girl? Fo show.
If not, our tech expert Roberto Esteban Rojas Fernandez, the third, is going to explain the rest.
Those using a drawing tablet will be able to use Adobe Lightroom, Photoshop, scribble handwritten notes, draw graphs, and utilize it for digital art, educational, and work purposes. Some even use a drawing tablet for digital whiteboarding ideas. So if the technology behind all drawing tablets is the same, why are there so many different models? Well, it all has to do with the features. For example, a super expensive drawing tablet will have an integrated, high-quality screen and offers an amazing drawing experience with high-pressure sensitivity technology and more. On the other hand, the cheaper graphics tablets do not have an integrated screen and usually provide less advanced drawing features. Choosing between a drawing tablet and a graphic tablet. Although most people confuse these two terms, there is a fundamental difference between drawing tablets and graphics tablets. Drawing tablets have an integrated screen that serves as a supplement to your computer screen. Graphics tablets, on the other hand, work as responsive pads and provide an active surface that automatically transmits everything to your computer screen.
Hello, it is me again, Roberto. Hihi. I am very, very sneaky, sir. We go over this in the Telonor webpage. The link is in the description and it might be easier to visit the link rather than listen to me.
Apart from this difference, the logic behind all devices and the technologies involved are pretty much the same. You could say that professionals should opt for a drawing tablet and beginners or students should opt for a graphics tablet. However, that would be too simplistic a view. In fact, many professionals prefer to draw on graphics tablets, even if they do not have a display. Since graphics tablets are usually much more affordable, we definitely recommend beginners to buy a reliable entry-level tablet like the latest Wacom 2s. Choosing a software to use your drawing tablet with. Let's say you just bought your first drawing tablet and plugged it into your desktop. What software should you use? Well, that depends entirely on your personal needs. There are many tasks that a drawing or graphics tablet can help you with. When it comes to drawing, most professionals choose either Adobe Illustrator for Windows, Krita or Procreate for Apple mobile devices. For photographers and photo editors, the best software are Adobe Lightroom Perfect for beginners and Adobe Photoshop for more advanced users. Finally, most 3D editors choose the latest version of AutoCAD and most animators use Autodesk Maya or Adobe Animate. Here are the features of a drawing tablet. Pressure sensitivity, tilt recognition, shortcut buttons, screen, and stylus pen. We cover much more on each of these. You can find this through the link in the description. Summary. A drawing tablet works by connecting an external pad that has sensors on it. Some of these tablets have a screen that you can draw directly on. They allow for tilt sensitivity, pressure sensitivity, and more depending on the model.
Hit the like button if you like my pointless orangeves.
Hit the like button if you like my pointless orange vest better.
Bob's chair. Or this chair.
In conclusion, a drawing tablet works by connecting a drawing pad to your laptop or PC. You'll connect it to your drawing software and also download drivers. You will also need a stylus pen, which many digital art tablets include. Don't forget, more in-depth information on this is also available. In 0.5 seconds, you can instantly see the steps and solutions, which is laid out clearly on our website. Go to Google, type Media Peanut, then how do drawing tablets work? Look for the Media Peanut website. You'll be able to instantly see the solution and view all the hard-to-find information you need.
Please subscribe to the channel, my friends. It will help you every day.